I consider this as a privilege to participate in this International Agriculture Platform and share some of my views relating to farm and farmers of the future, with a special reference to Asia. As we are all aware, agriculture is an engine of growth as far as Asian countries is concerned. It has been an old practice since last more than 5,000 years. And it is very diversified from country to country. And this is the region where we have also experienced green, white, and blue revolutions. Lately, we are also experiencing rainbow revolution relating to fruits and vegetable crops production. Many of these revolutions had been science-led. They had also contributed to household food security despite manifold increase in population. The agricultural production has in fact surpassed and ensured not only self-sufficiency, but made many countries capable of exporting several crops and commodities in agriculture. We are presently facing the second generation problems of green revolution, whether it is factor productivity decline, whether it is concern of soil health, water decline, biodiversity elimination, and also with regard to climate change. The region is experiencing also the challenge of two important sustainable development goals, that is the hunger and poverty. And therefore, we need to look at what could be the ways by which we can bring in the changes in our farm and farming practices. We need to reorient our research, agriculture, and development agenda, focusing more on innovations, and also bring in a paradigm shift from that of genetic enhancement relating to varieties and hybrids on which we capitalized in the past, then to go to also the second pillar of sustainability around natural resource management. We have to scale innovations which are likely to help us in not only improving our production, diversifying agriculture, ensuring secondary and sustainable agriculture, but also to see that we add value to our produce and ensure linking farmers to market. In the process, the challenge is also of involving youth in agriculture, youth including women, and to see how we can have an effective role played by them. While doing so, we have to recognize the importance of three cradles of agriculture for green revolution period. The first, the excellent policy support by many countries, including countries like Vietnam and Bangladesh, which have become now self-sufficient in food and also exporting rice to other countries, including India as well, where there is export of agriculture produce to the level of almost $40 billion per year. But then the concern of economic return to the farmer while the input cost is rising and soil health conditions are deteriorating and availability of water would also be less. So we have to now scale the innovations around natural resource management for sustainable intensification of agriculture and also to see that we improve soil health. We go for the concept of one health, soil health, animal health, plant health and also human health, and also in the process see that we are able to have the sustainable agriculture around secondary and specialty agriculture. Youth will not be interested more in traditional agriculture. We shall have to also diversify from cereal-centric approach to that of cereals and legume approach, like that of maize and soybean in the US, which has sustained agricultural production for decades now. And we have to see that whatever nutrients we are using, nitrogen use efficiency is only 30%, which will have to be enhanced. We have to go in for micro irrigation approach. We have to also think in the context of conservation agriculture by going in for minimum tillage or zero tillage approach, which has proved very successful in many parts of the world, especially in Latin America, US, Canada, and Australia. And at the same time, we have also to see that we don't let agriculture produce wasted because of lack of infrastructure and marketing opportunities. The region has done well in all directions, whether it is animal production, whether it is fish production, and there is great potential in terms of exploiting the rich agrobiodiversity, which is available, and there is great potential also for ensuring better adaptation to climate change and to adopt climate smart agriculture. In this whole process, we also see that there will be a need for reorienting research agenda from commodity and crop approach to that of farming systems approach, depending largely again on animal sector, which is contributing in many cases to at least 20 to almost 35% of agricultural GDP. We will have to spend more on agriculture research for development, and emphasis must now go not only for only research for research sake, but research for innovation and scaling those innovations which can make a difference, which can ensure more income to the farmers. Smallholder farmers will have to align themselves around farmer producer organizations or go in for contract farming or for self-help groups by which they can link themselves better to the market. We will have to involve youth to provide better advisory services as a paid extension, and also in the process see that we have inputs available to the farmers on time, inputs of the kind which can cut cost for the farmers, such as biofertilizers, biopesticides, micro irrigation, fertigation, and even to go in for diversified production like raising of mushroom, vegetables, medicinal plants, flowers, and so on. And in the whole process, there are tremendous opportunities which need to be harnessed. And for that, we would require at least a minimum 1% of agriculture GDP to be made available through policy support in all countries, as it is happening in many developed nations, so that returns on agriculture research, which are anywhere between 10 to 15 times against the investments made, would help us in ensuring secure and sustainable agriculture. In the whole process, we see that farms in future will have to be not small, but maybe reorganized through better land laws and policies, and through support for farmer producer organizations and better credit to the farmers, and also providing them needed support for diversification. and linking the farmers to the market and ensuring a better partnership with the private sector so that the benefit is not only to the farmers alone, but also to the consumers and to the nations mainly depending on agriculture in the Asian countries. Thank you.